everybody. Great to see you all today. I hope you all are enjoying the Olympics on TV.
Yes.
Swimming.
Yes.
Swimmingly or gymnastically.
Seems like that's all it's doing.
Every time I turn it on, I always.
I think they almost finished it.
Come to the face of heaven and earth. Come to the table of plenty. God will provide for all we need here at the table of plenty. Oh, come and sit at my table with saints and singers of
from 6 to 8 p.m. And then August the 10th, this next Saturday, you will see a flyer in your bulletin about an ice cream social. And our very own Amazing Grace Quartet, they will be playing. Please feel free to invite a friend and a neighbor. Give this flyer to your friend and your neighbor. Come enjoy fellowship, ice cream, singing, good time. Good time in the house of the Lord for fellowship. Then next Sunday, at August 11th, we will have worship. August 16th through 18th is Vacation Bible School. We are still in need of bubble wands, corn syrup bottles, corn paper, or there's paper rolls, the like crafty paper roll stuff, and contact paper rolls. Sorry about that. And then that's it from that. And then I do want to, yes, paper towel holders. If you need some of those, you finish up paper towel roll, bring it to church. And then, yes.
Question,
yes.
Corn syrup bottles, like, is it,
syrup.
We only need one more bottle.
Okay, one more bottle of corn syrup. One bottle of corn syrup. And then I would like to, here's a phrase that we have. This comes from our district superintendent, Beth Gibbons. A while back, we had an issue with the alarm panel and had an expense come up. And this just says, "Dear Matt and people of Salem Church, I know the experience with your security vendor has been frustrating. Please use this to help defray the financial burden. Blessings, Beth Gibbons." Mm-hmm. We've been given a $100 check to go towards that. So, thank you again, Beth Gibbons, our district superintendent. Another one last announcement we do have, sign-ups for t-shirts. If you want to order t-shirts, we got sign-up. They're going to be $20 a piece. And we get, I think it's 36. So if you're afraid the cost to, how much a piece?
She didn't give me a price. If the price breaks after 36, if we order 36 or more, it's a price break.
Okay. So if you want a shirt, sign up for a t-shirt. I know we've got like 12 so far. So, are there any other announcements? Yes.
Just a bizarre update. I have a sign-up sheet out there for baked goods, and if you're able to help anywhere, just sign up on the as-needed section. There are a few other slots available in rooms, but please do that. And I'm getting overwhelmed by boxes, so if you have some today, that's fine, but then kind of hold off a little while, because I don't have space for anymore.
Good. Okay. Hold off on the boxes. They're getting overwhelmed. So, are there others? Other announcements? If not, let's prepare our hearts and minds for worship. Thank you. join me in Paul's worship. Have mercy on us, O God, according to your steadfast love, according to your abundant mercy, blot out our transgressions.
Wash away thoroughly from our iniquity and cleanse us from our sins.
For we know our transgressions and our sins are ever before us. Against you we have sinned, and what is evil in your sight, we ask for your forgiveness.
Purge us with yourself, and we shall be clean.
Let us hear the joy and gladness. Let the bones that you have crushed rejoice.
Hide your face from our sins and blot our old transgressions.
Create in us a clean heart, O God, and put a new spirit within us.
And do not cast us away from your presence, and do not take your Holy Spirit from us. Restore my joy of your salvation, and sustain within us the Holy Spirit.
Would you please remain standing and join me in hymn number 420, Breathe on Me, Breath of God. Thank you. Good morning. How are you guys doing this morning? You guys good? So, I have a quick question for you. Have you ever been on a road trip? You've been on a road trip. I'm sure you guys have been on a road trip. So, what are some signs that you see on a road trip? Do you maybe see a sign like this? What does this sign say? Yes. Stop. Good. What about a sign like this? What's this sign say? Traffic light ahead. Yes. And what are the colors on the traffic light? What do they mean? What's red mean? What's yellow mean? Slow down. What's green mean? Go! What about this sign right here? It's a yield sign. What does that mean? Any guesses? Watch out. Good. Yes. So in the church, we are given different signs too. What does the cross remind us of? Jesus, yes. Now, I've got another element here. What does bread remind us of? It's a four, okay? Bread. What is bread? What does it symbolize? What?
Body of Christ.
Body of Christ, yes. Funny story. Last month I took the bread home from community, because you're supposed to consume it or bury it into the ground. So Mary, she saw the body of Christ sitting on the table, the round Hawaiian loaf, and she's like, "Daddy, can I have some of the body of Christ?" Melted my heart right there. Melted my heart. So this morning, what I'm going to be talking about is the body of Christ and how Jesus refers to himself as the bread of life. The bread of life. We are given symbols to remind us of Jesus and his love for us. Would you please pray with me? Holy God, we just thank you for this day. We thank you for the symbols that you've given us, whether it's stop selling, whether it's something as simple as bread, and how you can nourish us and sustain us. Lord, be with these kids as they go about their week and prepare for school. We just thank you and praise you for them. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. You may go to church, children's church, or back with parents. So where have you seen God break through?
Oh, yeah.
Where has God broken through? Yes, Jeanette.
I saw it all week because my grandson went to a Bible camp all week. So it was, you know, when you go pick them up, they're in a big circle in there.
Yes.
The owner or the leader of the group asked them if they want to come up and pray. They'll go up onto the stage and pray. And just about every kid would come up and say a prayer.
Amen.
So yeah, I saw God a lot last week.
Amen. We thank God for Bible camp and the impact it's had on our young children. Yes. You know, our children are the church today. I just praise God for that. Are there others? Others? Yes.
Yeah, my one great grandson had his birthday party yesterday and talking about Bible camp, there were a lot of kids there from Bible camp, and they got up and did this song and dance that they learned at Bible camp, and all the kids knew it. It was really great.
Amen. This church is going to get a chance to have kids on VBS in a couple weeks. Amen. Pray that we hear stories on that too. Are there others? Yes,
Patty. I finally made it to the ladies' Bible study Friday night. And it was just a really great, safe place, and we had a great time, and I just learned from each other.
Praise God. Ladies Bible study group, growing in Christ. Yes. Are there others? Other breakthroughs? I had a big breakthrough this past week. Got to spend time with family. Got to relax. Got to enjoy some downtime. Refreshing renewal. Thank you for allowing your pastor to do that. Are there others?
Yes. The hostages that Russia let out, I thank God that they are back home.
Others. Yes, Faye.
Is prayer request?
Yes, prayer. Praise God for protection, yes.
God is breaking through.
Yes, the simple things, yes. Yes. Yes.
I need prayers for my adopted son's mother, Georgia Johnson. She's back in the hospital with heart problems again, trustee general. I think she's going to be okay.
Georgia Johnson.
Georgia Johnson. And last week I asked for prayers from my friend Joey McGurk.
Joey McGurk.
Yes, sir, and he passed away Thursday. We appreciate prayers for the family. I have two daughters and a sister.
Joey McGurk. Pray for Betty Dixon. She's at home recovering. Thank you for all your prayers, the food that was sent. She's on the mend. I did talk with her this morning. Jerry is recovering from surgery as well. We praise God for successful surgery. We also want to keep Charlotte Flagg in our prayers. I did receive word that she's holding on. She was drinking coffee this morning. So praise God for that. Pray for the Harrington family, Tabitha and Joey's uncle, Larry Harrington. He passed away about 3 weeks ago. I'm going to be going up to Manassas and doing his graveside on Wednesday. So pray for the Harrington family. Are there others? Yes. What's his name? God knows. Yes. Yes.
I have a court on Wednesday, and Caitlin. There's a lot of things going on. So
don't forget your favorite.
Carol Tabor, yes. Any updates on Carol this week?
I talked to her. She sounds good.
Carol.
She's doing physical therapy, and she's able to walk, so
good.
She's walking around in her house. She just she just won't go through the door.
Okay.
But she's walking around in the house.
Good. Thank you.
Like to pray for the people in Florida that are in the storm, and pray for Georgia, the flooding that might appear from that.
Yeah. Definitely pray for what's in the path of Hurricane Debbie, or no, Tropical Storm, which I hear could be a hurricane. We might get some rain out of it this week. Watch the weather. Stay tuned for updates. If you don't have your hurricane kit, this is a tax-free weekend. Run out to the store, get some flashlights, batteries. Be prepared. Extra water, you know. Be prepared. And if you need anything, call the church. You guys have my cell phone number. Just, if you have anything, let us know. Stay tuned. Stay tuned. That's all I... Let's go to God in prayer. Holy God, we just come to you this morning. Thanking you for the many ways in which you've blessed us. Lord, we praise you for the ways you are breaking through. Lord, we've heard ways that you've broken through by grandchildren. Going to camp and coming back and witnessing, sharing what they learned, sharing those songs of camp songs, sharing their testimonies with their grandparents. Lord, we just thank you and praise you for this generation of kids and youth. Lord, we praise you for protection. When rocks come, and we thank you for the windshield that saves. Save us from harm. Just the tiny breakthroughs, Lord. The big ones, too, we praise you for that. Lord, we praise you for times of relaxation and time with family and friends. We just thank you and praise you. Lord, we thank you for the hostages that were released. And we just ask that you continue to bless them and give them strength. Lord, there are those on our minds who need a special touch from you. We pray for Betty, and we pray for Jerry and Carol and Rosanna and Kimberly and for Charlotte and for Georgia. Lord, you know the needs each of these people have, and for Carol. You know the needs each one of these people have. And Lord, we ask where there is healing, that you provide healing. Where they need comforting, where they need strength, that you provide them strength. Lord, we pray for Caitlin and her court date that's coming up. And Lord, we just ask, Lord, that you be very real and very present in it. Give her strength. Give her comfort. Give her your peace. Lord, we pray for those who have lost loved ones this past week. Lord, we pray for the McGinnis family and for the Harrington family. Lord, be with them and hold them near as they are walking through that valley. Help us, Lord, as a church to be your hands and feet to these people. Lord, we pray for our men and women in the military, that you give them your strength, that you give them your grace, that you give them your guidance. Lord, we pray for our government leaders, and Lord, we ask that you give them the knowledge that you provide. May they lead this country in a godly way. Lord, we pray for the unspoken requests. Lord, you know the need. You know the names. You know what's on our hearts. Lord, we just ask for healing and your peace. Lord, continue to bless us in our time of worship as we continue to worship you. For this we pray in the name of the one who taught us to pray together, praying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. I invite Linda Becker to come forward for our morning scripture reading.
Scripture reading comes from John 6, verses 24 through 35. So when the crowd saw that neither Jesus nor his disciples were there, they themselves got into the boats and went to Capernaum looking for Jesus. When they found him on the other side of the lake, they said to him, Rabbi, when did you come here? Jesus answered them, Very truly I tell you, you are looking for me, not because you saw signs, but because you ate your fill of the loaves. Do not work for the food that perishes, but for the food that endures for eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you. For it is on him that God the Father has set his seal. Then they said to him, What must we do to perform the works of God? Jesus answered them, This is the work of God, that you believe in him whom he has sent. So they said to him, What sign are you going to give us then, so that we may see it and believe you? What work are you performing? Our ancestors ate the manna in the wilderness, as it is written. He gave them bread from heaven to eat. Then Jesus said to them, Very truly I tell you, it was not Moses who gave you the bread from heaven, but it is my Father who gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is that which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world. They said to him, Sir, give us this bread always. Jesus said to them, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God. Would you please stand and join me in hymn number 640. Take our breath.
Take our breath.
Somebody please pray with me and for me. Holy God, we are yours. Speak to us through these next few moments. Open our hearts and our minds to receive your word this morning. Lord, speak through me and if necessary, inspire me. For Lord, you are my rock and my redeemer. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. So, as I was reading this scripture passage, there's one question I want to ask. How many of you like bread? I love bread. I see lots of hands on this one. Do you have a favorite kind of bread that you like to eat? What kind of breads are there? Yes. Sourdough bread. What other breads?
Rye bread.
What other?
Cornbread.
You know, that goes along with the ham and beans, you know, cornbread? Tortillas. Yes. Yes.
Cinnamon raisin.
Cinnamon raisin, okay. So I'm hearing all kinds of bread. Make me get a little bit hungry.
Good thing you have some bread.
There you go, there you go. So just about any restaurant you go in, you go into Olive Garden, you give them breadsticks, you go into a steakhouse, they provide rolls. And what happens with this bread? You eat so much bread, you're starting to get full. You come to your meal, what happens? You're full, you end up taking your meal home with you. Man. Have you ever wondered why they bring bread? Because bread is filling. Bread is filling. In this morning's scripture passage, Jesus said, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry. Whoever believes in me will never be thirsty. I'm reminded that bread alone is filling. When I eat bread, it fills me up. When we serve communion, like we're going to do in a few moments, what's the common element that we use? Bread. As I was talking with the children this morning, bread is symbolic of the body of Christ. We see that bread, and why is it used as, why do we use bread for communion? We see that bread is used in the Old Testament and the New Testament to signify God's substance of human beings and the importance of eating together. What do we do as humans? We break bread together, don't we? We eat together around table. We fellowship together. When God liberated the Hebrew people from slavery in Egypt, they carried bread with them. The Jews celebrated the Exodus throughout the centuries as Passover. God provided manna and the showbread, bread of presence, kept it in the tabernacle. God's substance from the time of Israel's wandering in the wilderness. We see this in Exodus 23 through 30. Let me read this for you. Exodus 23 through 30. He said to them, this is what the Lord commanded. Tomorrow is to be a day of Sabbath rest, a holy Sabbath to the Lord. So bake what you want to bake and boil what you want to boil. Save whatever is left and keep it until morning.
So they saved it until morning, as Moses commanded, and it did not stink or get maggots in it. Eat it today, Moses said, because today is a Sabbath to the Lord. You will not find any of it on the ground today. 6 days you are to gather it, but on the seventh day, the Sabbath, there will not be any. Nevertheless, some of the people went out on the seventh day to gather it, but they found none. The Lord said to Moses, how long will you refuse to keep my commands and my instructions? Bear in mind that the bread for two days, everyone is to stay where they are on the seventh day. No one is to go out. So the people rested on the seventh day. Where's bread in the New Testament? Jesus ate with his disciples and with others in Matthew 9, verse 11. We see Jesus eating with tax collectors and with sinners. I got to thinking, when you break bread together, like at a restaurant or around a church gathering, are you eating with people just like you? Or are you eating with people who are not like you? Say, for instance, you go to Texas Roadhouse. There's people of all walks of life, aren't there? Some are not like you. There's people different color, different backgrounds, different beliefs. Even different faith. And what's the all that people do? They break bread together. They break bread. Just like Jesus, he fed the sinners. He ate with tax collectors. He is the bread of life. The bread of life. I want you to think. How many bakers do I have in here? Two bakers. How many of you make bread? How many of you make bread? Okay, correct me if I'm wrong.
Can the bread count?
It's bread. When we break bread, when we make bread, it takes flour. Okay? It takes flour. Sometimes it takes yeast, and a little bit of salt, and a little bit of water. Just common ingredients. But church, with these common ingredients that we make together, creates something beautiful, doesn't it? A common element, such as bread. Creates something beautiful, doesn't it? Doesn't it? Body of Christ. Church. When we come to the church, we are come from different backgrounds, don't we? We come from different systems, different families. And we as a church are body family, the body of Christ. It's not the building. Jesus said, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will no longer be hungry again. Just think of how beautiful the body of Christ is. Church, I don't know about you, but I don't want to be hungry anymore. I want to feast on Jesus. As I was talking with the kids this morning, I was reminded of how life can get in the way. God will show us signs. Signs where We need to just take a chance and just stop for a second. Or maybe we just need to take time and slow down. Slow down. What does it look like to feast and be nourished by the Holy Spirit? What does it mean to feast on the bread of life? How do you feast on the bread of life? Do you participate in worship? Do you read God's word daily? Do you pray daily? I don't know about you, but when life has me going about in different directions, I want to feast on God. I want to feast on the bread of life because it nourishes me. Does bread of life nourish you? Church, my question for you this morning is, are you hungry? Are you hungry? This world can call us into different places, into different things. And sometimes I think that we have tendency to feed on the things of the world and not the things that can sustain us.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
My question for you this morning is, are you feasting on the ways of the world? Are you feasting on the nourishing bread of Christ, the bread of life, who offers sustainment for all people? Where are you this morning? My challenge for you this morning is to examine your hearts this morning as you come to the table. And if you're not being fed spiritually, if you're not being nourished by the bread of life, I challenge you to get in prayer. Dive into the Word so that you can be nourished by the Holy Spirit, by the bread of life. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. As we respond to God's word, I would invite our ushers to come forward. Let's pray. Holy God, we just ask that you take our tithes and offerings this morning. May they help us as a church reach out to the community. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. hymn number 641. Christ our Lord invites to his table all who love him, who earnestly repent of their sin, and seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us confess our sin before God and before one another. Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have failed to be an obedient church. We have not done your will. We have broken your law. We have rebelled against your love. We have not loved our neighbors, and we have not heard the cry of the needy. Forgive us, we pray. Free us for joyful obedience. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear the good news. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners. That proves God's love toward us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
Glory to God. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. And so, with your people on earth, and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join in their unending hymn.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice, in union with Christ's offering for us, as we proclaim that mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, and with the Holy Spirit, in your holy Catholic Church, in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, with the confidence of the children of God, let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. I'd like those who are assisting to come forward, please. This is the body of Christ, broken for you. The bread of life, broken for you. This is the cup of salvation, the blood of Christ, shed for you. For all who are thirsty, come and drink. In the name of this church, we practice an open table. What does that mean? The open table is Christ's table. Christ invites you to come and feast. Come and partake of the living bread, the bread of life, so you will no longer be hungry. The cup of salvation. It's not my table. It's not Salem Church's table. It's Christ's table. And he invites you to come forward. This morning we are going to participate in communion by a method called intinction. You will be given a piece of bread, and you will dip it into the cup. When you receive the communion elements, a good response will be, Amen. Which means, it is so. We do offer, if you need gluten-free elements, we do offer gluten-free. Just signifying gluten-free. And Mary will give gluten-free elements if you need gluten-free. We're going to serve Joe first, and then you guys will be invited to come forward. Table is set. Would you please come and receive the bread of life? Thank you. Let us pray. Holy God, bread of heaven, thank you for feeding us this morning, for giving us nourishment through your word and through the sacrament of Holy Communion. Thank you for setting us free from our sins. Amen. Would you please take turn in your hymnal to hymn number 395, Take Time to Be Holy. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. Amen.